Hi, I'm Carolyn Wainscott here with my friends at FaveCrafts.com, and today we're going to be making this work table organizer to keep all your tools and rulers that you need handy. For this organizer, I have cut two pieces. One piece would be the main body of the organizer. It was cut 42 inches wide by 58 inches long, because I have a very large cutting table here. The second piece will be a pocket for my very favorite ruler, which I need to get a new one, is this slotted ruler, and I like to keep that handy also, so it'll have its own pocket. The longest ruler that I have is 36 inches long, so I had to make accommodations for that, and then for the other rulers will all slide down into the same pocket. I want to keep my scissors handy. I want to keep my rotary cutters handy. It seems I always need a notebook, pens, tape measures, and my rotary blades. This is the bottom of the organizer. It's 6 inches deep. So I allowed 18 inches for this pocket. That's 6 inches to go up, 6 inches to fold back, and 6 inches for the back of the pocket. There's also 18 inches allowed for the next pocket. That'd be 6 inches up, 6 inches back for the fold, and 6 inches for the back of the pocket. These are all folded up and ready to go. But I'm going to fold the bottom pocket down. This is the fabric cut for the slotted ruler. It gets laid in next. And it will get laid into the bottom of the organizer, and this will get sewn in. While I'm sewing this in, I'm also going to sew some slots, separators, so that I can put my scissors, my rotary cutters, a pin cushion, and some tape measures in. So all that takes is horizontal lines to form those separations. The pocket, the large square pocket, is being top stitched down. Just top stitching it from the top to the bottom, so it'll hold that ruler in place so it won't be flopping out in my way. So I'm all time bumping it instead. It doesn't even have to be sewed across the bottom, because the bottom will be formed when I fold the bottom pocket back up. Now that that pocket is formed, I'm going to go back up to the other pockets and sew those segments. And I will be sewing to the bottom of that fold. The top stitching has been done all around. I did decide to put a little zigzag in it to give it a little pizzazz. And right now I am on the squared pocket, and this will be done. So here's bottom pocket for the long rulers, square pocket for the slotted ruler, and segmented pocket for the my tools. I did leave an 18-inch flange for the back. This will go under my cutting board. And I left this long because I don't want it slipping out if the rulers decide to slide down a little bit. So I'm going to put this in place and put my tools in there, and we're ready to go. The organizer is done. I have it 18 inches under the cutting mat so that it won't fall. Here's my slotted ruler and my scissors, a tape measure, pins, rotary cutters, and the cutting blades. And here are my cutting rulers. And so they're all handy, and all I have to do is reach down, and if I can just remember to put them back in there, maybe I won't be perennially looking for something. Seems I'm always looking for something. Now this is my work area, work table, and I like it high so that I don't have to bend over when I'm cutting and working on fabric. So actually this is a dresser that my mother-in-law and father-in-law started housekeeping in over 80 years ago. And I like the piece. It has drawers in it for storage. It's just the right height. And then here's the organizer that I just made. The top of this that I can take off at any time is actually a closet door. We had some renovations done several years ago, and I salvaged all the doors because I like them for tabletops. This has some padding underneath and then canvas. So the whole door is actually an ironing area. I can press and iron if I have large pieces of fabric. All I have to do is take the cutting mat off of it, and I'm good to go. So I like my big work area.